an out-of-this-world scientific sample 7 years in the making.
Touchdown. I repeat, FRC has touchdown.
For the first time in U.S. history, NASA is returning an asteroid sample from space. CNN Space and Defense correspondent Kristen Fisher has more on this remarkable mission.
Well, Fred, the OSIRIS-REx spacecraft left Earth back in 2016. Since then, it has traveled more than 4 billion miles to the asteroid Bennu and back before finally releasing a capsule over the United States on Sunday morning. And, you know, inside this capsule was about half a pound worth of rocks and dust and soil from the surface of the asteroid itself. And this is really the first time that NASA has ever done anything like this. This capsule entered the Earth's atmosphere. You're traveling at about 27,000 miles per hour. It hit temperatures of about 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit before finally landing in the Utah desert at just about 11 miles per hour, thanks to some pretty big parachutes, which help slowed the landing. From there, recovery crews that had been training for years for this very moment swarmed the capsule. They were able to check it out, make sure it was still intact. It was. They were able to make sure it was not, the battery was not leaking any toxic fumes. It was not. So from there, they were able to safely transport it to a clean room. And from there, it's going to be going on to the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, where it will be opened and revealed to the public in about 2 weeks. And that is where scientists are going to be spending the next few years really looking into what exactly this sample has returned. And this is a sample from the asteroid Bennu. It's a very ancient asteroid from the beginning of the time around when the solar system was formed. And so scientists are hoping to gain some insight into if this is the kind of asteroid that could have perhaps seeded planet Earth with the elements that were needed for life, things like water and carbon. There was a belief that it was these types of asteroid that upon impacting Earth, we're able to seed it with those elements, give it the elements that were needed to create life here. So scientists are going to be looking into that. They're also going to be looking at the planetary defense side of things, because there is a very, very small chance that this asteroid could hit Earth in about 150 years from now. It's a small chance, but it is a chance. And so NASA wants to study as much about it as possible.
What do you think about this? I mean, this is cool stuff. What kind of information do we think we're going to get from this space rock?
Well, it's nothing less than perhaps unlocking the key to how life got started on this planet, Jim. So big stuff.
Okay. Yeah.
You can imagine this planet about 4 billion years ago not being such a cushy place for life, mostly magma. But as it cooled off, a lot of scientists believe these days that it was bombarded by asteroids that brought perhaps the building blocks of life, amino acids and carbon, and some of the ingredients that make it all possible for us to have this conversation billions of years later. What's interesting about asteroids is that, you know, we here on Earth have gone through all kinds of tectonic and geologic activity in the meantime, sort of covering up all the evidence. But asteroids, it's like having those ingredients in a deep freeze out there in space. And if you could go and grab some of those ingredients and take a look, which is what this mission did, maybe you'll solve some big questions.
And how did they do it? I mean, how did they get this rock off of that asteroid? If I could just ask a basic question there, I'm kind of amazed that we were able to do this. It's kind of cool.
The short answer is very carefully. It's a 7-year mission. They flew to Bennu, which is a near-Earth object, which incidentally will fly very close to Earth in the coming years and could potentially put a bullseye on us, but that's another story. But the trick with Bennu is it's only about 1,600 feet across, so there's really no gravity there. You can't really land in any meaningful way there. And so they did what amounts to a pogo stick-style bonk on that asteroid, sucked up some of these rocks and went off on their way. So the 7-year mission was only about a few seconds of actually collecting the samples.
Interesting. And it sounds like Bennu is a bad boy. Is that the deal, Miles? I mean, you were just saying a few moments ago that this thing might hit the Earth in 100 or 200 years from now. Are we going to have to get Bruce Willis up
Bennu
there?
Bennu in the next decade or so.
And all that?
Well, is Yeah, it's been slated to fly between the moon and Earth in the next decade. And depending on how that goes, in another 50 years beyond that, it could very well have our number painted on it, and we need to watch Bennu very carefully. It's one of those near-Earth objects. Now, this is an asteroid that won't cause a dinosaur-like extinction event, but it would. It's about the size of the Empire State Building and would cause a huge regional catastrophe. So it's important that NASA keep a close eye on Bennu.
And we have the technology, do we not, to potentially deal with that? I suppose in 100 or 200 years, we damn well better have the technology to deal with it if we've got to do something to that asteroid. We've just experimented with knocking these things off course.
Yeah, just about a year ago, almost exactly a year ago, this DART mission proved that we could, you know, auger into an asteroid and perturb its orbit ever so slightly, but just enough if you do it far enough in advance to make a spectacular light show as opposed to a regional catastrophe.
Very interesting stuff. All right, Miles, well, we knew you were the perfect person to go to on this. We appreciate it very much. Great to see you as always. Thanks, Miles.
You're welcome, Jim.